fought obstacles everywhere. Being bullied, being teased. As a parent, man, that hurts. He went through all that. He overcame all that. Look what he's doing now, man. He's playing Bar City football.
He's got a great work ethic. He was voted by his peers as a team captain. You know, he plays because he earned the right to play, not because, of his circumstances. He goes out and performs at a high level. He's one of our best wide receivers. Football a long time, and got to play it. Now I get the pleasure of coaching it. And to be completely honest with you, Markey has completely redefined perseverance in my mind. For a young man with one arm to go out and play wide receiver in Texas in high school in 6A, yes, he's an inspiration, not only to the kids that play beside him and the coaches that coach him, but the teams that we play against, they're all asking about Markey, you know, and he's never sought any special treatment. Before, I just thought it was persevering through an injury, a sprain, a knee surgery, or some adversities at home or in school. But when you look at Markey and you look at the hand that he was dealt in life at an early age and his desire and passion for football,
he doesn't hold back at all. He doesn't quit. He's a stubborn child, very active. He doesn't quit. When he's got his mindset on something, he's gonna do it.
He is a unique person because I don't think my son understands. He has a handicap. My son doesn't realize it yet right now, what he is doing. It's not what I've done with him. It's what my son has done. I take no credit for what my son has done. The only credit I take is I have him.
So persevere means to keep going. Don't give up. You can't just lay down and quit on life. You have to keep on going. Because once you give up on life, you're going to give up on yourself and everybody that cares about you.
When Markey was little, he was very, very headstrong. He would, whatever he wanted or whatever he wanted to do, he was just going to do. You know, don't get in his way, he's coming. He was like a little train and he was coming. They called me and told me that Markey had broke his arm.
Markey was on top of a tree, branch broke, fell off the tree. What do? You know, take him to the hospital, you know, put a cast on it.
When we got to the hospital, I of course thought he was gonna be okay also, just a broken arm. But a couple of days later went by and it was not that good.
Fever started running. We started calling, you know, doctors. We started calling all kinds of doctors. And everybody directed us to Texas Children's Hospital. And they took him in right there. No hesitation whatsoever. It was just like, all right, get the kid in, and that's it. Guy says, hey man, we gotta take his arm off. I lost it.
When this occurred, I couldn't see how a child could deal with what was going on.
what killed me the most is when he's, you know, they're taking him away because they're like, hey, Mr. Leal, you can't go, you gotta stay here. Like, no way. And, you know, Marky's screaming, you know, Dad, don't let him take me. Don't let him take me, Dad.
Brought the whole family together. We didn't even know the amount of support we had back home. I mean, everywhere. I couldn't believe it. And people were sending us stuff, and there was a prayer chain for him in Mexico, Houston, Chicago, Georgia, everywhere. It was unbelievable. Unbelievable.
Everybody was against it. But with my son, that's what he wanted. That's what he fought for. I'm gonna do whatever it takes.
This was a decision Marky made himself, and he really wanted to do it. And he's never said can't. He's always worked hard. He's always tried. He's always achieved. He's one of their best receivers with one arm.
Especially after all he's been through, man. You know, I would have never thought when that accident happened that the kid would be playing football right now. You know, and for me to be a part of that right now in his high school years, I think that's really cool. One of the first times I ever really sat down and got to know Coach Leal, you know, Marky's story came up. And the impact that it had, not only on the family, but the community. You know, and the adversity that they faced with Marky at such a young age and his arm having to be amputated for whatever reason. I could just tell how much it impacted him as a father and a coach, and Marky as a young man. I think they've done an amazing job of getting past it, though, and pushing forward. I love the game because I love stories like Marky's. I love persevering stories like Marky Leal, where you know you're dealt a raw deal at a young age, and a lot of people would just kind of succumb to their circumstances. But yet here you got a teenager who's overcome so much at an early age. You know, I just think football and this story should be an inspiration, not just to athletes out there, but to businessmen and women.
Those are passed up by number 28, Marcus Leal. People think I can't do it, but like calling you guys an easy target, it makes me want to keep going. I'm not just gonna give up on me or my teammates or anybody that's counting on.
It's really a simple story about a kid that had a dream, willing to work his tail off and overcome anything life threw at him in order to achieve it.
He's an inspiration to all of us. The obstacles you have in your life are maybe obstacles that you put there. Change your view and not look at it as an obstacle. You can get through anything. And this young man, my nephew, did. He did.
If you want it, you can get it. If your kid really wants it, be supportive and go at it. Don't ever let your kid's dreams fall short. The only person in this world that could ever tell your son that he can't do it should be God, and only God.